Hi everyone, this is Dr. Barnes. I just wanted to give you a little bit of information about myself and maybe you can get some idea about the point of view I'm taking on this class. I'm a Kentucky native. I lived most of my life in Louisville. I went to Mayo High School when it was still downtown, so I'm super old. I went to Hanover College for my undergraduate work. There I studied philosophy and cultural anthropology primarily. I did graduate with a BA in philosophy, and then I went on to my master's work at the University of Louisville. My master's work was also in philosophy, and there I studied primarily formal logic and phenomenology. After that, I taught for a little while, and then after a couple of years of teaching, I decided that it was time for me to go into the Army to pay off my student loans. Strange decision, perhaps, but we weren't at war, and it seemed like a good idea, and so I went. I kind of wanted to study the Asian languages. I'll tell you why shortly, but what ended up happening was that the definition of an Asian language was sort of changed up on me, and I ended up studying a Near Eastern language, maybe Asia Minor, some might say, in that I studied Arabic. So I did become functional in Arabic, and as a result of that time, studying at the Defense Language Institute in Monterey, California, I was assigned to the National Security Agency. I finished out my career in the Army at the National Security Agency. I did not retire. Between my active duty service, 5 years, and then 2.5, almost 3 years of reserve service, put in about 8 years in the military. Overall, again, a lot of that at the National Security Agency and a lot of that at the Defense Language Institute in Monterey. So after that, I wasn't very happy about all the things I'd done for my country. We had gone to war in Afghanistan and Iraq during that time. I was intimately involved in those activities, have operation badges to prove it. And then I was also a person who worked with the Palestinian-Israeli conflict quite deeply at the National Security Agency. And so I felt like there was maybe a lot of, there were a lot of problematic issues with my government service. So I wanted to do something for the good. So I went to law school at the University of Louisville, came back home. At the time, had a young family, and they were in Louisville, and I wanted to be back with them. And so came back and went to law school. I was there about a year before I figured out that was not the right place for me. And so I dropped out of law school and started teaching. Didn't start teaching right away, though. I needed a job a little bit quicker than that, and so I went to work at a grocery store called Wild Oats Markets. It was in St. Matthews in Louisville. It used to be the nation's leading competitor to Whole Foods. I was at Wild Oats for about 3 years. Became a grocery manager after I was a produce clerk and a cashier and a bagger and a grocery clerk and a bulk supervisor and a dairy supervisor. Anyway, bunch of jobs in the grocery store, as some of you may know. So worked in Wild Oats, and that was the first time I ever got a good sense about sustainability. Honey Brothers Coffee contacted us since we were selling their coffee and asked if we want to be involved in a composting project. And we were really unsure what all that was about, but we used Will Allen's model at Growing Power in Milwaukee to develop Breaking New Grounds. Some of the videos for Breaking New Grounds are in your media list for the course. You can watch those. And so that was a sustainable agriculture project intended to create both economic and social sustainability as well by teaching people to grow their own food and making some income from the project so that we could hire employees, which we were able to do. Breaking New Grounds folded in 2012, but I was able to start the University of Louisville Community Composting Project late 2009, and that continues. There's information about that project on the internet and in your media list as well. And I did return to teaching at several universities, including Bellarmine and U of L. During that time, I also returned to U of L to finish my PhD, which I did, and that's why I'm Dr. Barnes, I guess. Anyway, my PhD is in interdisciplinary humanities. The focus of of my program was philosophy, and so still I had a lot of philosophy classes, and my dissertation is squarely in philosophy. I developed a technique for writing a textbook based upon the Paul Elder critical thinking model developed by Richard Paul at the Foundation for Critical Thinking. I've also done postdoctoral work at the Foundation for Critical Thinking, and I am a junior senior member of that organization. The title is scholar. Anyway, so I do critical thinking workshops, and critical thinking is heavy in all of my classes, which is why you have some requirements in your syllabus around critical thinking, which you should take very seriously because I do. Even if you don't care, it might be a really good idea. So I've been teaching now at the university level for about a dozen, 13, 14 years. I'd have to add it up right now at the making of this film in 2017. I also do some entrepreneurship on the side. I founded a few companies. Some of them did well, some of them not so much. I'm in Panama teaching right now. I teach with the Panama program at the University of Louisville. I'm down here twice a year to teach business ethics and introduction to logic. That's one of the reasons why this online format fits what I do pretty well. I also have a small sustainability administration position at the University of Louisville. Sometimes that position's paid and sometimes it's not, but that's the way these things go. And I help work with programming and volunteer activities. I direct the Echo Reps program, which is about peer-to-peer sustainability education and service. And I have a few other hats at U of L, although you find me primarily in the philosophy department doing work there. I also own a small martial arts school. I guess that takes us back to the Asian language thing. I study Japanese, but I'm not very good at it. I've been studying it for a long time. And I went into the army thinking that I would be able to get a Japanese language class, and maybe I would be able to learn that language a little bit better, or maybe some Chinese, right? But it didn't work out that way. Arabic was what was needed, and that's what I did. And my Arabic is okay now, but I don't really practice it much these days. So that's kind of my story. I have a 17-year-old son. He's very interested in a lot of the things I'm sure that you guys are. I don't know. I'm just living a life. And I hope that we can have a good time together this semester. You should always feel free to reach out to me if you have questions. And I hope that this brief introduction to my background has been useful. I am engaged in all sorts of sustainability projects all over town. I've worked with a lot of different groups. At the making of this, at the time of the making of this film, I'm about to join the board of Louisville Grows. I'm also involved in some other nonprofit boards, I work with the sustainability efforts at Bellarmine and at U of L and at IUS. At Bellarmine, one of the things that you should think about checking out if you're around there this semester is the Bellarmine Farm, which is across the street, adjacent to Our Lady of Peace and behind the building. It used to be the Bellarmine office building. I don't know what it's called now, but that one building across Newburgh Road. Where the environmental studies program is housed. There's a pretty cool working farm behind that with an orchard and an asparagus stand and a bunch of raised beds, composting, rainwater capture, herb garden, a bunch of cool stuff there. So something to check out when you're looking for sustainability projects or some sustainability research. If you have other questions about my sustainability work or anything about me, please reach out and have a good class.